not a great look. Help the mixer out a little bit. If you're looking for the best way to get smooth, delicious, and creamy buttercream, except without any dairy, you're in the right place. Today, I'm gonna be breaking down my top 3 tips for you to get completely vegan buttercream. I know it seems like a completely crazy idea, how to make buttercream without butter. It can be done. Hi, I'm Natalia Lima, founder and owner of Curious Cat Bakery, an all vegan bakery based out of Florida where I make everything taste exactly like the real deal. And guess what? My vegan cupcakes are award-winning, thank you very much. And so I'm gonna be explaining to you some of the tips that I have that will make that buttercream completely indistinguishable from the real stuff. Are you ready? Let's do this. So many people are very stumped by this idea of vegan buttercream because they've tried it in the past and it's either grainy or it doesn't have the right consistency, it melts easily. And I do have a series of videos about vegan buttercream. You can check out one of them over here where I explain why things might be melting and not looking quite right. I also have this one video over here that is a comparison of using vegan butter, margarine, or shortening for your vegan buttercream for you to decide which one works best for you. Now, I personally like to use vegan butter, which again, I explained in this video over here, and I think that gives you the best results. So my tips are gonna be related to having vegan butter in your recipe. Now let's get to those tips. So my first one is to use cold vegan butter. So one of the reasons why your buttercream might be melting and just looking a little and not have really a consistency that stays in a shape on top of your cupcake, for example, might be that your butter is just not cold enough. So when you put it in the mixer, make sure that it's like straight out of the fridge. And maybe you're gonna have to cut it into pieces like cubes or something like that before you put it in the bowl. Because if you put it in just one big chunk in there, what's gonna happen is that the paddle from the mixer is just gonna sink into the butter and it's not gonna move because it's too cold. So help the mixer out a little bit. Cut it into pieces, throw it in there, and then let it beat until it's completely smooth. And that's when you're ready to start adding the sugar. You're ready to start adding the sugar. Here comes tip number 2. Make sure that sugar is sifted. So what happens with powdered sugar is that when it comes in a bag, it starts to clump up. And that's because the humidity clumps up. There's no other way of phrasing that. It just does. So some of it will be loose and some of it will be like little pebbles of sugar. You don't want that. While it is a pain to have to sift your ingredient before adding it in, believe me, it's worth it. Because if you put those clumps of sugar into the stand mixer, your line of thought is that the paddle is just going to break those clumps, but that's not always going to happen. And what you might end up with is just clumps of sugar that get blended into the butter, and then you don't have that smooth texture. You have kind of lumps in there, and that's problematic for 2 reasons. One of them, you want your buttercream to be smooth. That's part of the whole thing and what makes it delicious. Second of all, a lot of people complain about buttercream being too sweet. That's one of the reasons, because your sugar is not evenly distributed, and because you have clumps in there, you're gonna have to add more sugar for it to become the right consistency. So now you have clumps and added sugar, and that just makes it too sweet. You sifted your sugar into a bowl and now you're gonna start adding it to the stand mixer. So when you do that, you wanna have the mixer going at a low speed, otherwise it's going to blow up and you're gonna have sugar everywhere. Not a great look. But also, you wanna start adding little by little. And here's the key for this. If you add it all at once, some of it may sink to the bottom. It's just not going to mix thoroughly. You also have no control over the consistency. So you might add all of the sugar and then find out, oops, that was a little too much. And now this buttercream is too dry. Now you're gonna have to add liquid for it to get to the right consistency. And now you're messing with the recipe. If you do it little by little, and let the sugar incorporate into the butter as it mixes, you have full control of the consistency so you can stop adding. Because sometimes that happens. Sometimes you need a little more, sometimes you need a little less. So if you add it a little by little, you're gonna get complete control over the consistency that you wanna achieve, if you want it harder, if you want it softer. You also make sure that no sugar is wasted at the bottom and that it all gets incorporated evenly. I said there were 3 tips, but I'm gonna add a 4th bonus one. So let's just say, even though you did all of the things because you are so great at following instructions, you still messed it up a little bit and the consistency is a little too hard and you're going to have to add a little liquid to make it softer. The way to do it is to just do it 1 teaspoon of plant milk at a time. So I prefer to add almond milk. I think that's the best kind of milk to add to buttercream. And I add 1 teaspoon at a time. And you may think, oh my God, what a waste of time. I'm just gonna add like a tablespoon or a few teaspoons at a time or just a splash. Oh God, don't do the splash. Don't do the splash. It's not gonna come out well. Just add 1 teaspoon at a time and then let it beat for a little more. 1 more teaspoon if needed. Do it slowly. I know it just takes more time. It's not great. You have things to do, you got places to go. However, if you want your buttercream to turn out right, you don't want to add a splash of milk and now, oops, now it's too soft, add a little more sugar. That's how you end up with buttercream that's either going to split or it's going to taste too sweet because now you had to add more sugar because you added too much milk. You don't want to mess with the recipe. If you have a chance not to mess with the recipe, take it. So just do it slowly. Make sure you get it right the first time around. I hope this video helped you in getting the best results for your vegan buttercream. If you're into vegan baking, you might want to download my free guide to successful vegan baking. I'll put the link in the description below. You just go in there, put in your email address, it gets delivered straight to your inbox. I will see you guys here tomorrow with a new video. Until then, you might want to watch this video over here where I troubleshoot a lot of the problems that people have with vegan buttercream, or this one where I do that test comparing the different kinds of base for vegan buttercream to find out which one is best. I will see you here next time. Until then, stay curious.